There are over 3 million apps on the Play Store, and I'm about to show you 10 of my absolute favorite best Android apps that you can get for free. Let's get right into it. One of my current favorite Android apps is Plane App. It's an open source application that lets you manage your phone through a web browser. The setup is the easiest thing ever. You just download it, give permissions, type in the address into your browser. That's it. You've got instant access to all your files, videos, photos, music, and even contacts. Everything is encrypted and all the data stays only on your phone. You just access it through the internet. And the best part, no ads. This app is an absolute time and patience saver, so I bow my head to the creator. On my very long quest to find the best weather app for Android, through the advice of Reddit, I stumbled upon WeWow. It's clean and easy to use, but best of all, it's accurate. I can even select a data source. If you're not sure which one is the most accurate for your location, look up your zip code or city on the Forecast Advisor website. WeWow has a premium version, but even the free version doesn't have any ads. When was the last time that you saw that in a weather app? On top of that, it has some nice widget options and there's plenty of space for customization. If my advice is not enough, look at this glorious 4.9 rating. Beautiful. Next up, the best Android app for video editing. To me, that's CapCut. No, I don't make CoolTechZone videos on it, but for slightly simpler stuff like TikToks or Insta stories, it works. It has a powerful free version and it's easy to use, yet at the same time, there are plenty of useful tools. Background remover, speed controls, color correction, filters and effects, and drum roll please, no watermark. Boom, case closed, best editing app ever. What about the best VPN on Android? Tons of options on the Play Store are straight up scams, so your best bet is to look for widely established names. My personal pick is NordVPN. No, this video is not sponsored. In fact, I'm about to dish out a little secret. You can actually get NordVPN for free. Sort of. They have an Android exclusive free trial, so if you've never used it before, go grab it. It's one of the safest VPN choices, and I really like its ad blocker feature. If you decide to keep it, don't buy it straight from the app and pay full price. You can save a lot of money with a coupon code, which, FYI, you can find in the description below. Sticking to the privacy theme, what's the best messaging app for Android? Introducing Signal. It's my go-to private messaging app. It's owned by a nonprofit with a recently updated open source code, and everything in it is end-to-end encrypted. On top of that, it's very intuitive and easy to use. The only con is that not everyone has it, which we should all be collectively fixing, so go and get it. All right, what's next? Jesus, okay, okay. All right, Duo, calm it. Jeez. Duolingo, one of the best Android apps for learning. It's one of the first language learning apps with courses in over 40 languages for free. That said, the teaching methodology is definitely not for everyone. I find it useful to learn the basics and kind of have it as a daily reminder to sharpen my skills, but if you want to go much deeper into language learning, a surprising honorary mention is YouTube. Yeah, no, I'm dead serious. All right, moving on. Recently, I made a very exciting discovery, launchers. Unlike with iOS, we Android users don't have to be stuck with a single default launcher. And upon a little bit of testing and investigation, I grew to really like the Nova launcher. You can pay for a full Nova version, and many people do, but the free one is insanely customizable. There are thousands of app icons, and you can control the color of almost every single detail. So yes, very impressive. By the way, for those looking to get a very minimal launcher, the Niagara launcher stands as my honorable mention. Let's move on, and I've got a note-taking app recommendation for you. Noto. It's great if you're looking for a note-taking app. Of course, it's free, and it doesn't have ads. Plus, like many apps on the list, Noto is open source. I really like the sleek and simple design, but there's a surprising amount of customization options here. I can create folders for different types of notes and pin them, add names, colors, labels, etc. I can also archive stuff, and there's even a folder vault for privacy, which can be locked with a password or fingerprint. I also have an honorable mention here, Obsidian. It's a bit more technical. You can program it to extract data into charts and interactive graphs, and add all kinds of other plugins. All right, let's also find the best navigation app for Android. And here I have to say, Google Maps. Sorry, but the amount of different functionalities it has currently outshines all other options. It works no matter if you're walking, driving, or taking the bus. There are plenty of features too, like making lists to mark places I want to visit or share recommendations with my friends who are coming to town to visit. For car and motorbike users, the Google Maps versus Waze debate comes up. And I like Waze. It's often better at finding the fastest routes and avoiding traffic. Just that you won't find restaurant reviews or bus schedules here, so it's less functional overall. And last but not least, I nominate Cashew as the best app for personal finance. It has both a free and a premium version, but for me, the free one is plenty. The app's open source and uses the golden standard AES 256 encryption to keep your data safe and private. It can take a bit of time to set up and get used to, but then it quickly becomes easy and convenient to use. Cashew is fairly customizable too, and I really like the smooth animations. I also like it when people subscribe to my channel, so please press that red button or at least like the video if you decide to get one of these apps. I really recommend at least trying Plane App, grabbing a free NordVPN trial and checking out the launch. Thanks for sticking around till the end. Comment below with your own app recommendations. Maybe I'll test them out myself and compile them into another video. Cheers!